It's the Morning Culture, hey. The ATL's number one for hip-hop and R&B. And ladies and gentlemen, she is in the studio. The one and only Pinky Cole of Slutty Vegan is in the building, ladies and gentlemen.
Girl.
Man, the phenomenon that has taken the city of Atlanta by storm. She's been featured all over. Everybody knows her.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Yes. Girl.
And I gotta say this. How do you find time to be a restaurateur at the same time you're still, like, producing television and everything else? Because you work with Iyanla Fix My Life and everything.
Yeah, as of 2 months ago. Well, first of all, I'm just happy to be here.
Hey, girl, we are so happy to have you. Fellow vegan
this
in the house, sister.
This is the blessing business right here. It's two people, one to my left, one to my right, the OG to the top.
Stereo,
absolutely.
Girl. Stereo.
I'm so grateful to just be in y'all presence, number one. And
likewise.
This has just been an amazing roller coaster ride for me. I'm Jamaican, so I could do all things through Jah who strengthens me. So. So, you know, having so many things on my plate at one time, this feels right. And that's how I know I'm walking in alignment with who I am. So I'm just blessed. I'm just
good
happy
for
to be
you.
Here.
So can I narrate the experience? So yesterday, you had us come to Slutty Vegan.
Yes.
At your address here in Atlanta.
Yes.
And I remember getting off the highway, getting off 20, coming down the street. And as soon as I got to the corner and turned the corner, I see a line of people down the street.
So many people.
And it wasn't for Jordan.
No, you're short.
It wasn't
Girl,
for Jordan.
It was for you.
Changing the length of that line.
Yeah, it was insane. It was insane.
Okay, the line went two blocks.
Yeah.
And
that was light because the weather was bad.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. I overheard
Girl.
Folks in the front saying that they were waiting at like 1:30, 1 o'clock.
But
and
you
it
see
opens
how
at
beautiful
four.
Atlanta is? Like these people wait for 5 hours.
Yes.
For vegan food.
A vegan girl. That makes my heart so filled with joy.
It's a beautiful feeling because it's not just burgers and fries, right? This is like a vegan revolutionary movement,
yes.
right? Especially for people who look like me and you. So for the people to support me in the way that they have been, like, I cannot describe it in words. And they continue to support me, good, bad, and indifferent. Whether rain, sleet, snow, they're there and they support. And it's just a plus that the food is damn good.
Girl, so good. Did you expect that in Atlanta? You know, the black culture, like you said, that's not even a part of our culture normally to be vegan.
No, you know, I've owned a restaurant before too.
Right.
Yeah, so I had a lot of people there, but I never imagined it to be like this. And I'm just grateful for the Atlanta support. And I think it's time. Like,
yes.
We are in a cultural movement where, like, people, white, black, blue, we're all walking into the truth. And a part of that truth is eating healthier and knowing that it doesn't have to be dead to taste good.
Right,
you
know
what
on.
I mean? What, let me ask you, your other restaurant, what was it?
So it was a Jamaican restaurant. It was called Pinky's in Harlem.
Harlem.
145th between 7th and 8th. And it did extremely well. But I wasn't equipped with the proper tools to do what I needed to do. But I needed to be in that space because the universe provided me with so many lessons that I was able to bring into Slutty Vegan, right? So that restaurant burned down after 2 years. And I got a great opportunity to work on Iyanla Fix My Life as the casting director. Hey, Iyanla. And I was on that show. So we relocated to Atlanta. So while in Atlanta, I'm like, you know what? I'm ready. Like, I feel like I'm getting ready for the Super Bowl. Like, I want to do this again, but I want to do it in a different way.
Yeah.
So then when I came up with Slutty Vegan, everything just shot up from there. Like, I can't even begin to tell you, like, the steps that it took because it literally happened, not overnight because I've been doing this since I was a little girl.
Right.
But this was right. Like, it's right.
Yeah, so, just all in alignment.
All in alignment.
Go, girl.
So when I saw the concept, and first of all, I got to shout you out because you a CAU grad.
Yes.
Hey.
Delta Sigma
Delta
Theta Sorority.
Theta.
All right.
Miss Clark Atlanta.
Yes.
Miss Clark Atlanta.
Yeah.
So okay, so when I saw you go from the food truck to the brick and mortar building, I told Dean, I said, that's brilliant. Because you got your concept.
Absolutely.
You started it small. Once it hit, you said, you know what? Now it's time to expand.
Yeah.
And so many people get an idea and they go into the brick and mortar like
me. You're too big.
Right
away.
You
know, when I did my restaurant, I went right to the brick and mortar. It was like so big. I was like, oh my God, this is overwhelming.
Right.
But you did it at a time when you were ready and the experience to do it. And it's so streamlined.
Yeah. But the beautiful thing is, it's a beautiful fear every single day, right? So I'm not going to sit here and say I have it all right, because there are days, like, I literally get ready for the Olympics every single day.
Right.
This morning, I woke up like, okay, Pinky, what you going to do to take over the world? Like, that is the mindset every single day. And I don't have it all right. But the beautiful fear is that I get to challenge myself every single day.
Yes.
And because I have so many people rooting for me, I'm like, I got to make y'all proud. But, like, I got little girls, little boys, everybody. You know what I mean? So it's just like, I got to do this.
The amazing thing to me is that you started the truck last August, no?
Well, first of all, I started in a shared kitchen.
Wow.
Wow.
So cooking in a shared kitchen. The first week, I had 4 customers. So I sat down, I'm like, God, what do you want from me? Like, whatever you want to do, do it, right?
Yeah.
And the next week, I had 100 people out the door.
Wow.
And I owe a lot of that to, her name is Plant-Based Princess. She's the first person that posted me. And she's a really big vegan dessert maker in Atlanta. Mm. She posted me, and literally I had... It got so big, I almost got kicked out of the facility that I was in.
Wow.
Yeah.
So have you
good
been,
problems.
Right, no, good problems. Have you found a lot of people that are now converting to veganism just from trying your food?
Well, Slutty made them vegan.
Hey!
The good thing about Slutty Vegan is that you don't have to be vegan to eat it.
Right.
So there's a mindset that, like, vegans are boring, mundane,
right,
and they always push their agenda on you.
Right.
So we're creating an experience for you that you feel welcome. Like, you feel like you can come home, and it's not, like, in your face. Like, we're throwing it at you, and if
right,
you don't eat it, something's wrong with you. No, we're creating an experience. We're creating good food. And it's like the know and love. Now they know what Slutty Vegan is. Mm-hmm. Now they love it. And now they trust
and
it.
And I think it's a beautiful transition into people who are trying to go vegan and realize
Absolutely.
That there's so many options, right?
Absolutely.
Like, you don't have to just eat leaves.
This is just the introduction to a bigger conversation.
Yes.
And I told you right before we took a break, I had to ask you the big question. Where did you come up with the name Slutty Vegan, and why slutty?
Mm. I was a slut my past life. It's funny, because when I came up with this concept, I wanted to be able to, like, meet the people where they were, right?
So, right.
Historically, when you hear a vegan, like, for years, and this is factual information, it was a rich white lifestyle. Right.
Right.
And not to take anything away from anybody. Either black people didn't have the resources, the information, or the money. We just didn't know. And that's not everybody. I'm just generalizing. So I'm like, how can I connect the people to this lifestyle so that we can eat healthier?
Right.
I'm like, I know that sex sells. Okay. So how can I positively manipulate this, right? In a good way. So there's an underlying lesson here and something to be learned. So when slutty, it came like a light bulb. And I'm like, slutty.
Yeah.
Because when you think vegan usually is boring, it's fresh, it's clean, and nothing is wrong with all those things, but for somebody who's not used to that kind of
right.
lifestyle, to them it's foreign.
Yeah.
So then when I started connecting the names, the provocative names, I'm like, okay, this is going to get people's attention. And now once I have you, then I can guide you into
yeah.
the truth. Then I can show you a different way. And again, it's vegan junk food, right? So this is the beginning. But if I can open up your mind to really see food in another way,
yeah.
especially if you go to another restaurant, not only are you think about Slutty Vegan, you're going to think about what vegan or plant-based options they have on the menu, and it may open up the horizons to do something different.
Very
so that's
good,
what it was.
You
girl.
Got me.
It has nothing to do with sex. So I've been getting like some backlash about
yes, it does.
Slutty.
Yes, it does. Because after we ate it, I felt like I had sex and it was good.
It was so good, good.
It's about indulging in a thing that you love, right?
Let me tell you, sis. I am a vegan, yeah. right? My husband's a vegan. My son's a vegan. So I brought the burgers home. Girl, I have had vegan burgers in my life, but this one literally changed my life. I was the sauce, the drip from that burger. Girl, you put your foot in that. I am so impressed. It was literally the best vegan burger, honestly, that I have ever had.
The best one.
The best one. Says the vegan. But yo, no, it is. It is. The hype is real. And I'm so, so proud of you, girl. Black
Thank
girl
you.
Magic is
so
beautiful.
So is it safe to say that you've been slutified?
I have been slutified.
What about you,
I have been slutified. So let me ask you a question. So having a vegan burger... A lot of people have it.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know, they said in the article you use the impossible meat
right.
to do it. Everybody has that. Not everybody, but a lot of the restaurants have that.
Right.
What makes yours so different?
The secret isn't, well, first of all, and I tell people this all the time, like, I put a lot of energy in everything that I do.
Yeah. Okay.
Everything I do is 100%, nothing less. Like, I wouldn't do it if it wasn't that. And we put a lot of energy and a lot of love into the food.
Yeah.
Okay. Right? So if you ever walk into my restaurant, the energy is always on 1,000.
Yeah.
My employees, how they feel.
And they are all black, girl, which I love that you are employing black people
Absolutely.
In this community. It's so beautiful.
Absolutely. So the secret is in the energy, and the secret is in the soul.
That's sauce.
That sauce, baby.
Girl.
Yeah, the secret is in the sauce.
It's so good.
And we don't just serve the Impossible Burger, so we have a lot of other plant-based and vegan items. Impossible is what I started with.
Okay. Yeah.
So it was kind of like the forefront of Slutty Vegan, but then, you know, I branched out and I have some other items, but we also have new menu items that we're adding,
which is
pretty cool because we were talking off air.
Yeah.
We switch the menu every single day.
So
it gives the consumer something to look forward to. So you just don't come every single day for a number one or a number five.
Well, like, last night I had a one night stand, so I don't know what I'm going to have today.
Where's she at?
In his belly.
In my stomach.
Yo, no, it was so good. Like, honestly, after my husband ate his, he wanted to eat the rest of mine. Like, it was so good.
And that is a part of that experience.
Yeah.
Right? So, like, even for the people who stand in line, people stand in line and come through the door and are still happy because it's a badge of honor to, one, to say that you're supporting a black-owned business.
Yes.
Two, to say that you're fellowshipping and coming together with people who are like-minded. And if they weren't like that before, they're in line talking about healthy living and lifestyle and networking. Mm-hmm. And it's just a beautiful thing. And to be able to take people away from their phones for at least an hour.
Yeah.
Look how tuned into technology we are. So now people are willing to stand in line and meet other people. We don't do that anymore. So there's so many benefits to Slutty Vegan.
Yeah.
It's bigger than just cheeseburgers and fries.
Honestly, to your credit, like, I've had Impossible Burgers before. It is not,
it's not
the same, y'all. I'm
telling
you.
So you said you even have, like, JR, you had some different things here yesterday.
Yeah.
But then you even said you had a sausage yesterday.
Yeah, so we also used the Beyond Meat sausage.
Oh, nice.
And that's my favorite.
They're
actually.
So good.
It's called
I didn't
the Big
even
Dog.
Know.
Yeah.
I'm coming.
You said it's called what?
It's called the Big Dog.
Big Dog.
The Big Dog.
Yeah, it's an Italian.
Reggie, she got a Big
hey,
Dog.
Reggie Red. Yo, yeah. I love the name.
Yeah, it's the Big Dog with sauerkraut and our special sauce on a pretzel bun. It's so good.
Mm, girl, I'm going to have to come back and try that.
I was posting on my social media yesterday. I had a lot of folks reaching out. How is it? How is it? How is it? I'm not vegan. I just like to eat food.
He's
I told
foodie.
People it was better than beef burger.
Yes. Ooh, my on, brother.
That's just facts.
Do y'all hear this B103?
You want me to say it again?
Say it again.
What I had at Slutty Vegan was better than most, if not a lot, of beef
now.
Burgers.
We don't even need to eat the animals, y'all. Yes. Get
and,
more connected.
And let me say this. The brilliance, and I love, like, the business side of, and
yeah.
the brain and how you do it.
You.
To walk up to that place. You see the line. The organization from your staff was amazing.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
They let you come in. You see the menu. Yeah. It's not big. It changes every day.
Not at all.
Okay? And there's a few options each day. You order. You walk down the line. Mm-hmm. You see them make it fresh.
Yes.
It's not already pre-made.
Nope.
They make it fresh. They put it in the bag. And you walk out.
Yes.
They let more people in. It's mm-hmm. like the business side of it. Is freaking amazing.
It's a seamless assembly.
My
line.
Last question is, what do you have planned for Super Bowl with all these people coming to Atlanta?
Whew, we have a lot planned. So one, we're doing a Welcome to Atlanta on V103.
Yay!
We got a lot of special events going on. But bigger than that, just get ready. Like this, like we come.
How many
one,
trucks are hitting the street?
Two.
Yes.
Ooh.
Plus the restaurant.
Upgrade.
Okay.
So if anybody is out there coming in town, like we're looking forward to getting you slutified. And also, like if you're an entrepreneur, like you could do this too.
Yeah.
And you can
okay.
do it better than me.
I'm gonna need
Ooh,
a slutified
girl.
Shirt.
Yeah, I want a slutified shirt too.
Everybody listen. The address is 1542 Ralph Dabin Abernathy in Atlanta's Westview neighborhood.
Yes.
You are making the neighborhood hot. I know your neighbors love you because you brought so much business there. They might be mad because
oh,
the parking
mad,
is bad.
But I love them.
But they bring in the business.
Yes.
And we just want to say, listen, Pinky, thank you so
yes.
much.
So
we
much.
Appreciate it. You are fabulous.
Thank you.
And you know what? I know you work on Ianla's Fix My Life.
Yeah, you
But
see
I
it.
See your own show.
Oh,
your
yeah,
personality and everything.
Absolutely.
I see your own show.
For sure.
I see your own show.
She out here doing it for the culture,
yeah.
y'all.
Pinky Maybe show. One day you'll be interviewing us on your show.
Yeah.
All right, Pinky Cole, everybody, Slutty Vegan. One more time, the address for everybody to know is 1542 Ralph Dabin Abernathy Boulevard in Atlanta's Westview neighborhood.